and 10. Johnson will go deep. Strelo in the corner of the end zone. Touchdown, North Dakota State.
Thank you. Strela, what a catch. Inside the five, down to the 1 yard line. How about that?
There
he is in prime range. Here comes the blitz. Johnson, John Gill in the right end zone. Nelson beats his man easily. Touchdown, North Dakota State.
Thank you.
It is a special time in Fargo, the beginning of fall practice on the campus of North Dakota State University. And at first glance, this August looked a lot like the year before and the year before that. But this fall camp was different. For the first time in 4 years, there would be a new starting quarterback. And for the first time in recent memory, the supporting cast was the strength, and the unknown commodity would be the man under center. It was the million-dollar question: who would drive this offensive machine? There were questions to answer on defense as well. The good news was that the Bison had been learning, building depth and experience all along. That improvement would be tested early as the explosive offense of Ferris State came to town for the 99 opener. Bob Babich gave junior quarterback Ryan Johnson the nod for game one, and it took exactly one drive for Johnson to earn the favor of the Fargo Dome crowd.
A lot faster. Johnson straight drop back across the middle, complete to tight end Jared Peck, and he's alone to bring down. It takes two Bulldogs. First and 10. Johnson will go deep. Strelo in the corner of the end zone. Touchdown, North Dakota State.
Johnson's first quarter numbers, 6 for 6, 97 yards, and one touchdown. But it wasn't just the arm of the quarterback that had the Bulldogs reeling. It was also the feet of sophomore sensation Lamar Gordon.
A lot of room and a lot of speed to the 20, the 10. Touchdown, Lamar Gordon, North Dakota State.
28 carries, 154 yards, and four touchdowns. Every time the Bulldogs got close, the Bison answered.
Gordon can walk in. Touchdown, North Dakota State.
And no one had a better sense of theater than senior special teams ace Tim Strelo. In the third quarter, Ferris State had made a game of it with a kick return score. Then the guy who would later earn the nickname Touchdown Tim dropped back to return the ensuing kickoff.
Yes, sir! Touchdown, North Dakota State. No flags.
The lead was 24 points, and the Bulldogs were out of snarl. 55-35 was the final. Ryan Johnson had passed his first big test of the fall. The Bison looked ahead to Cross River rival Morehead State.
They execute well. They're competitive, and other than that, I don't see us having much problem with them.
Whatever upset plans the Dragons might have had were quickly dashed. NDSU scored the first four touchdowns of the game, including the second special teams touchdown in as many weeks for Tim Strelo. The senior wideout also grabbed two touchdown passes. The Bison spread the wealth offensively, with six different players reaching the end zone. The defense did its part too, limiting the Dragons to 7 first half points. The scoreboard operator would earn his keep on this night as the Bison tied a school record with 71 points. And everyone got into the action. Most importantly, it was a chance to build depth and confidence on both sides of the football, and those tools were especially valuable with the conference season straight ahead.
So let's just continue to do things right off the field so we can continue to climb on the field. That is the goal, man. Next week, we start the NCC.
As an offense, it's probably, the best in the nation right now, so. The way we figure it, no matter what, we think we have the best defense in the nation. So we're going to go in and try to shut him down, shut down Lamar Gordon, and handle him after that.
NDSU doesn't run that complicated of an offense. I think defensively we can shut him down.
The St. Cloud State Huskies had also won their first two non-conference games, and they weren't short on confidence as they prepared for the trip to Fargo. The Bison would do their talking between the lines, and it was sophomore linebacker Wade Kittleson who would make the first statement. The Bison defense, which had been overshadowed by its offensive counterpart, was the star of this game. The Bison beat the dog out of the Huskies' offense, limiting St. Cloud State to 174 offensive yards and no offensive points. Meanwhile, a star continued to rise in the Bison backfield. Sophomore tailback Lamar Gordon scored twice from inside his own territory. A 35-6 decision meant Bob Babich's team was 3-0 and had crafted a 7-game winning streak going back to last season. But win number 8 would have to be earned away from the friendly confines of the Fargo Dome, game number 4 at the University of South Dakota.
It's a good stepping stone for where we're at now. Even as well as we played tonight, there's still a few plays that we need to iron out and get taken care of, and I still think the potential of the defense hasn't been hit yet.
The Coyotes gave NDSU an early wake-up call with a touchdown on their first offensive play. But the Bison responded quickly and ensured the Coyotes there would be no Saturday night surprise in Vermilion. Ryan Johnson used his arm and his feet to even the score. Then Lamar Gordon worked his way in from 7 yards out to make it 14-7 after one. Quarter number 2 was the Tim Strelo Show, now playing in an end zone near you. First, a 58-yard catch and run for a touchdown. Then Strelo skipped 52 yards with a punt return. It was 31-14 at halftime as the Bison offense handed a 17-point lead to an inspired defense. Donovan Larson's linemen got the pressure, and Andy Rondo's defensive backs got the picks. NDSU forced 5 turnovers in a 45-14 rout. Offense, defense, and special teams, it was a total package. But as the Bison walked off the field, business taken care of quickly gave way to business yet to be done. Win number 4 was in the books at the University of South Dakota, but win number 5 would have to be earned at the University of North Dakota.
It's a day when hearts beat faster and blood pressures run higher. It's the best day of the year for college football fans.
It was a day made for football. 40 degrees. 2 unbeaten teams, 1 heralded rivalry. The Bison were looking to get their hands back on the Nickel Trophy, and just a minute 43 in, the Bison served notice that they meant business today.
We'll score for the Bison!
The Bison defense played a nearly perfect game, but one critical mistake gave UND a 3-point halftime lead. The comeback challenge was steep, as starting quarterback Ryan Johnson had left the game with a shoulder injury. Backup quarterback Dan Schultes performed admirably under pressure, and Aaron Peterson was on the mark from 37 yards. It was 10-all early in the fourth.
Justin Beam, the long snapper, and it is good.
But the UND defenders held, and a late field goal would round out the scoring. 13-10 UND was the final. It was a tough loss to take, but the Bison knew there was still a lot of football to be played, and a conference title was still well within reach. Homecoming 1999 saw the Augustana Vikings travel north to the Fargo Dome, where the Bison were looking for their 7th straight home win. Ryan Johnson was back in the lineup, and Casey Bradley's defense was improving by the quarter. But the first points in this game were tallied by the special teams unit. Luke Schaefer stunned the Vikings with a 66-yard gallop to make it 7-0. The second quarter produced 10 Bison points on the strength of a Johnson to Strelo 38-yard connection. Meanwhile, the Vikings, tired of no yards in a cloud of dust, had all but crossed the running plays off the playbook. At halftime, Augustana had amassed a total of 1 rushing yard, and it was 17-7 NDSU. A Lamar Gordon 1-yard burst got the Bison all the insurance they'd need. and the right foot of Aaron Peterson went 3 of 3 on field goals as the Bison improved to 5-1 with a 30-14 win. NDSU had given up a total of 8 rushing yards, but a much tougher task awaited.
Next week is a big game against South Dakota State down there. Tough place to play. Let's not take time to get it going and crank up the level of emotion. Let's do it from the start.
The last time the Bison had seen Josh Rannick, the South Dakota Stater sliced through the defense for 282 yards and 3 touchdowns. But there would be no heroics today. The sophomore sensation was held to just 91 yards on 19 carries. Meanwhile, Lamar Gordon was piling up the yards behind an inspired group of offensive linemen. Bruce Somm's Rams took their smash-mouth style to the Jacks front 7, piling up 233 rushing yards. The Bison defense held the home team scoreless until the fourth quarter. By that time, NDSU had piled up a 28-0 lead. 28-7 was the final as the Bison moved to 4-1 in the NCC, 6-1 overall. The Bison defense was at the top of its game. That was a good thing because looming on next week's schedule was perennial conference power, Nebraska-Omaha. No one needed to remind this group what the Mavericks were capable of, and no one had forgotten last year's trip to Omaha. In its first series, the Bison defense issued a statement to the boys in red and white. It may have worked last year, but you're taking on the wrong team in the wrong place on the wrong night. 5 possessions, 5 Nebraska-Omaha punts. It was 3-0 early in the second quarter, and neither offense had been able to hit its stride. But on 4th-and-2 from the Maverick 47, Mark Maurer called on number 28 to pick up the first down. Lamar Gordon had bigger plans. The 47-yard score ignited the crowd and the Bison offense. Next possession, Ryan Johnson called on the young but skillful hands of redshirt freshman Mark Bratton. 17-0 North Dakota State. Next possession, Gordon off the right side, and the Bison had built a 24-0 lead. The Mavericks tried to fight back, but the hole was too deep. A Tim Strelo 8-yard grab put the finishing touches on an 8-game home winning streak. The Bison defense allowed just 2 third down conversions in 13 attempts. The high-powered Omaha rushing offense was held to just 3 yards a pop. 31-14 was the final. The Bison were 7-1, 5-1 in the conference.
We just wanted to send a message that we're not a pushover and that we are a good team and that there's not just a really good offense here in Fargo, there's really good defense also.
Big question in week 9 was, would NDSU look past Minnesota State Mankato? It would have been easy to be distracted by the upcoming trip to Northern Colorado. But the Bison offense quickly assured those concerned that complacency would not be a factor. The Bison came in planning to pound away at the Mavs. There would be no reason to change. Glenn Caruso's running backs ran for more than 200 yards. In all, NDSU gained 353 on the ground. Ryan Johnson did sprinkle a pass here and there, and when he did, the results were impressive. 3 of his 9 completions ended in the end zone. One of them went to Tim Strelo. It was a fourth quarter score that was number 25 of his career, and that was a new school record. And when you've set an offensive record at North Dakota State, you've done some work. The Bison had 8 offensive possessions, 6 ended in touchdowns. The Bison defense had allowed just 205 yards and 14 points on 57 plays. The home winning streak had reached 9, but the biggest game of the year would be away from Fargo. Next week's battle against once beaten Northern Colorado. Mother Nature provided a near-perfect day. Bison versus Bears, the game the entire conference would be watching. Both teams came in 6-1 in league play. Both offenses had been lethal. Both defenses had been stingy. It was punch and counterpunch early, but in the second quarter, the eventual Harlan Hill winner stunned the Bison with 3 touchdown passes. But the Bison rallied with the final 10 points of the half to cut the gap to 28-13. The third and fourth quarters followed a similar script. The Bears score once, the Bison strike twice.
Coming back, we're coming back.
6 minutes into the third, Lamar Gordon scampered 56 yards to make it 35-20. Then one of the candidates for play of the year, a scrambling strike from Ryan Johnson to a diving Tim Strelo. At the end of 3, the Bison, once left for dead, were within 9.
Cut, touchdown! Tim Strelo!
UNC scored early in the fourth, and again it looked like a Bears win. But with 4.5 minutes to play, Ryan Johnson found Eric Nelson in the end zone, and it was again a one-possession game. The defense, which had been battered all afternoon, dug deep and found a way to get the ball back. Bob Babich's team hoped to force a punt. The defense did one better.
Unbelievable!
5 plays and 21 yards later, Deshaun Perkins had given the Bison what an hour earlier seemed almost impossible. A chance to force overtime in a 41-39 game.
For Johnson, zips it, tipped away by Morlock.
The comeback would fall 2 points short. And while the effort was courageous, the result was heartbreaking. It was the kind of year where 9-2 would not be enough.
We learned a valuable lesson here today. We had it right here, man. We had it in our hands. We could taste it. When we look back and we say we lost 41-39 in the way we played in the first half, we're just going to be sick. That's something I can promise you. I can promise you that. But once again, hold our heads high for this reason. We continued to fight. We kept coming back. We kept coming back. We made plays at the end of the game. We never said die.
The Bison knew their playoff chances were all but gone, but if there was a way, a convincing win at Morningside would need to be part of the equation. Lamar Gordon kickstarted the offense with another patented long-distance dash. The Bison would get 6 on their first 3 possessions, and at halftime, the lead was 28-6. Bison D slammed the door shut in the final 3 quarters, allowing just 186 offensive yards to NDSU's 503. 38-6 was the final. Nothing was official yet, but slowly the realization set in. The team that had lost 2 road games by a total of 5 points to 2 playoff teams would themselves be denied a chance to play on. If ever there was a season that illustrated the fine line between those who go and those who don't, it was the season of 1999. The leadership of 12 seniors made it a possibility. Howman, Dahl, Simmers, Gilbertson, Strelo, and Nelson on offense. On defense, Knorr, Bowl, Stephan, Gibson, Skyberg, and Samuel. They may not reap the benefits of the 2000 season, but they have built the foundation. The Bison are loaded with experience and depth heading into the new year. NDSU returns more than 20 players who started at some point during the 99 season. The decade of the 90s began with a national championship, and the Bison have all the tools to start a new decade the same way. The pieces are in place, the tradition is alive, and the Bison will be heard from in the year 2000.